Egypt and football. Two words that, when combined, always produce the name Mohamed Salah. And although he's an excellent footballer, when compared to another Egyptian, he doesn't make it at the top. If you ask any African fan about their favorite footballer, only one name will come to their mind. This is the story of the most talented footballer that stayed loyal to his homeland and never played in Europe, despite almost every single one of European clubs wanting to sign him, claiming that he could never betray the club that made him who he is. This is the story of Mohamed Abu Traika, the footballer that became a symbol. The year is 1978, and our protagonist is getting born. Little is known about his personal life, except for the fact that he's married, with 3 kids, and he has graduated from Cairo University with a Bachelor of Arts in Philosophy, which is pretty impressive given the fact that he started working as a professional footballer quickly, as his talent was apparent to every single one of the executives that watched him. At the age of 12, he joined the youth squad of the Egyptian side of Tezana, at the time a first division team. He didn't find it difficult to show his extraordinary talent, and at the age of 19, he made his professional debut without magic to impress immediately. However, from 1997 to 2003, he managed to score 91 goals in 165 games, an impressive stat for a young attacking midfielder. When his club decided to renew his contract with better wages, Abu Traika showed signs of his character, as he refused to sign the new and improved wages if some of his teammates, who he knew were struggling financially, did take some work. He insisted that he had been playing just as well as them and that it would be an injustice for him to accept the offer. Until the end, he refused to sign the contract, while at the same time helping his side to come back to the first division. Al Ahly, one of the most prestigious clubs in Egypt, took notice and knocked on Tezana's door for his signing. And signing he did. For his first 13 appearances in 2004, he scored 11 goals, becoming the league's second top scorer. Abu Traika's effort with Ahly led to attention from the Egyptian national team. He started the game against Trinidad and Tobago in a friendly match before the World Cup 2006 qualifiers on 13 March 2004 in Arab Constructors Stadium. The first starting game for Abu Traika ended 2-1 for the Egyptians. He started as an attacker, but was found to play better when he played his normal position behind the attackers in the attacking midfield position. Abu Traika scored his first national goal in this game. He scored 5 goals in his first 6 appearances with Egypt between 2004 and 2005. In 2005, not only did he help Al Ahly with the Egyptian Premier League, but he also won the CAF Champions League, scoring an amazing goal in the final with an outrageous effort from 30 yards out against Etoile Sportive du Sahel of Tunisia in a game that ended 3-0 for Al Ahly.
بيلعبوا لابو تريكا خدها لنفسه المرة دي وعماد بدأ بيتحرك له وشوط جو 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 يا ولد يا ولد يا تريكا مش ممكن مش ممكن مش ممكن.
In 2006, he scored 26 goals in 35 appearances, winning many trophies and nominations. He was an unbelievable talent. At that point, many teams in Europe had taken notice, but Abu Traika was simply not interested to leave his club. He continued his excellent form for many years, scoring incredible solo goals and having top-notch assists, ending his career with 116 goals in 271 games for domestic club football, while scoring 38 goals in 105 appearances for Egypt. It was apparent from his early years that he could do incredible things with the football. Many were calling him the Egyptian Zidane for his flair, his technique, his creativity of the game and his outrageous goal-scoring abilities. Despite his selflessness off the pitch, he was ruthless on it. Many stories have been developed around Abu Traika, with the most notable one proving that he had no interest in money. For all his years in Al Ahly, he was signing a blank check without demanding anything. The club's chairman was to decide what to give him, as he stated, "The love for my club is bigger than anything else." People loved him, and that for him was the highest price. On the 1st of February 2012, a massive riot occurred at Port Said Stadium in Port Said, Egypt, following an Egyptian Premier League football match between Masri and Ahly. 74 people were killed and more than 500 were injured after thousands of Almazi fans stormed the stadium stands at the pitch following a 3-1 victory by their club and violently attacked Ahli fans using clubs, stones, machetes, knives, bottles and fireworks, trapping them inside the Al Ahli partition of the stadium. Many of the deaths were due to political refusal to open the stadium gates, trapping the Ahli fans inside, leaving some to die and killing others in a stampede while trying to escape. Abu Traka was shocked. He initially wanted to retire from football as he visited each one of the victims' families. Later, he decided to carry on with his career to honor the lives of those who were murdered. I always say that as a footballer, you have a message that you can convey besides football. And that is what he did. On the 5th of January 2008, Abu Traka, after scoring a goal, revealed the shirt with which he showed sympathy for Gaza and its victims. It was that day that he became a hero for many in the African world. He ended his career winning multiple domestic titles and the CAF Champions League. The Italian sports journalist Gabriele Marcotti has also been highly impressed with Abu Traka and praised Abu Traka's career with some words that describe him the best. He is possibly the greatest footballer in the history of the world with a bachelor's diploma in philosophy hanging on the wall of his sitting room. He's arguably the best footballer on earth not playing his trade in Europe or South America. You may have had no idea of who he was, but for all the football fans that had the chance to see him play, he was simply the best. A paradigm of a footballer that tried to do the best with what was given to him. A national hero.